We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today the Church celebrates the memorial of Saint Augustine. We have an image of him in front of us. It was Saint Augustine who reminded us that our hearts are restless until our hearts rest in God. Let us ask the prayer of Saint Augustine, that in our lives we may always search God, who will really give us the meaning to our lives. In this Mass, let us also pray for the safety of everyone, especially those who are living in low areas. To make ourselves less unworthy of this Eucharistic celebration, let us humbly ask God's pardon and mercy. Have mercy on us, O Lord,
for we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy,
and grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Renew in your Church, we pray, O Lord, the spirit with which you endowed your Bishop Saint Augustine, that filled with the same spirit, we may thirst for you, the sole fount of true wisdom, and seek you, the author of heavenly love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second letter of Saint Paul to the Thessalonians. We instruct you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to shun any brother who walks in a disorderly way and not according to the tradition they received from us. For you know how one must imitate us, for we did not act in a disorderly way among you, nor did we eat food received free from anyone. On the contrary, in toil and drudgery, night and day we worked, so as not to burden any of you. Not that we do not have the right. Rather, we wanted to present ourselves as a model for you, so that you might imitate us. In fact, when we were with you, we instructed you that if anyone was unwilling to work, neither should that one eat. May the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times and in every way. The Lord be with all of you. This greeting is in my own hand, Paul's. This is the sign in every letter. This is how I write. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways. For you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Behold, thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Please stand.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Your word is a lamp for my feet and a light on my path. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You are like whitewashed tombs which appear beautiful on the outside, but inside are full of dead men's bones and every kind of filth. Even so, on the outside you appear righteous, but inside you are filled with hypocrisy and evil doing. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You build the tombs of the prophets and adorn the memorials of the righteous, and you say, 'If we had lived in the days of our ancestors, we would not have joined them in shedding the prophets' blood.' Thus you bear witness against yourselves that you are the children of those who murdered the prophets. Now, fill up what your ancestors measured out." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, yesterday in the Gospel and today in the Gospel, the Lord spoke about inside and outside. Inside, outside. You cleanse, for example, in yesterday's Gospel, you cleanse the outside of cup and dish, but inside they are full of plunder and self-indulgence. In today's Gospel, the Lord spoke about whitewashed tombs, clean outside, but inside are full of dead men's bones and every kind of filth. And He called those people who are cleaning outside and dirty inside, who are clean outside and dirty inside, Jesus called them hypocrites. Why is it so? Why is it that we, including ourselves, focus on the outside and forget what is inside? Because it is easier to look good than to be good. It is easier to look good than to be good. You just wash your face, take shower, and you are already clean. That's easier. But to fill your heart with love, to be kind, to remove any degree of envy or hatred, that is more difficult. And that is why we tend to do the easier job. We tend to choose the easier task. Maglilinis na lang ako ng mukha kaysa sa magpatawad. Maliligo na lang ako kaysa mag-isip ng mga mabubuti. And that is the warning of Jesus in the Gospel. Do not focus only on external cleansing. Do not forget that the internal cleansing is also as important, or perhaps even more important, than cleaning outside. And so the question is, how do I protect myself from focusing on the outside, forgetting the inside, on focusing the outer cleaning and forget the inner cleansing? Maybe by examining ourselves frequently, by looking into ourselves more frequently. Like before you left your house, you look at the mirror. I hope, no? Tinignan nyo, pantay ba yung buhok ko? Pantay ba yung kilay ko? No? Baka yung mga kilay nyo, ha, hindi pantay. You look at the mirror because you want to see yourself. So similarly, we have to look into our inner mirror, our conscience, and ask ourselves, what is my intention for doing so? What is my motivation for doing so? Kasi kapag hindi natin tinitignan ang ating kalooban, hindi natin napapansin, dumudumi na. Hindi ba sa bahay, ang madalas nating nililinis ay yung nakikita? Pero minsan, kinakailangan angatin natin ang mga upuan, angatin ang kama, sapagkat nandoon sa ilalim ng kama yung dumi. Pag hindi natin yung binibisita ng regular, naiipon ang dumi sa ilalim sapagkat hindi natin nakikita. Today, the Lord is inviting us to look into our hearts, to examine ourselves and see what is in there, so that we will not be only focusing on what is seen by others, but also at what is seen by the Lord. Kasi ang dali namang manloko ng ibang tao. Magpakita ka lang ng maganda, pwede na. Kaya hindi ba kapag pangangampanya, yung mga kandidato, laging nakangiti yan, no? Hindi kasi simangutan yan, no? Okay? Kasi inaawitan nila at nililigawan ang boto mo, magpapakita ng ganda, ng ngiti. Nakikita natin. Pero merong isang lugar na hindi natin maikukubli sa paningin ng Diyos. At yun ang ating puso. What do you think does God see in our hearts? Saint Augustine, whose feast we celebrate today, memorial we celebrate today, wrote a book called The Confession. There, he wrote everything that happened, even his sins, his evil thoughts. He confessed everything to God. That, I think, is what we need. Sa harap ng Diyos, sabihin natin, Lord, ito po ako. Nababasa nyo ang nilalaman ng aking puso. At tignan nating madalas, ano ba ang nilalaman ng ating puso. Amen.
Please stand.
We ask our Lord to help us to be sincere in our actions. Let our response be, Lord, read our hearts and answer us.
Lord, read our hearts and answer us.
That in our lives as members of the people of God, we may fulfill the demands of the gospel by our constant witnessing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, read our hearts and answer us.
That we may avoid doing things out of the desire to conform or out of hypocrisy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, read our hearts and answer us.
That those discouraged by our displeasing manners and behavior may return to worship by our renewed life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, read our hearts and answer us.
That the sick may see the healing hand of God in their trials and difficulties. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, read our hearts and answer us.
That those who have departed from this life may be received into eternal glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, read our hearts and answer us. Father, help us to come to worship with a sincere heart, so that we may be able to approach you in spirit and in truth. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Celebrating the memorial of our salvation, we humbly beseech your mercy, O Lord, that this sacrament of your loving kindness may be for us the sign of unity and the bond of charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For us on the festival of Saint Augustine, you bid your church rejoice. So too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, including Augustine, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. May partaking of Christ's table sanctify us, we pray, O Lord, that being made members of His body, we may become what we have received through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My dear sisters and brothers, it's Wednesday again, and tonight at 9 p.m., we will have our regular Wednesday family rosary online. And tonight, our host will be the community of San Roque Parish in Pasay City. So that will be at 9 in the evening via our Facebook page, Manila Cathedral. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Pinamalang piling ka, ipinamalang.